find the equation of the tangent to the function when x is equal to cos t and y is equal to sine 2t at the point t is equal to negative 6349. Now this is in 4dp, so we'll try to write the corresponding values in 4dp. Okay, so yeah, the first thing that we need to find is when t is this value, what's the corresponding value of x and y. Now as this is a parametric trig function, one thing that you need to remember is your calculator should be set in radians. Okay, so here let's start with finding what is x and y. So x is defined as cos t. Cos t, so x would be cos of negative 0.6349. So let me, so if you use a calculator, the value that you're going to get is 0.8051. I'll show this on the calculator later on. And y is defined as sine of 2t. Sine of 2t. So that would be equal to sine of 2 times negative 0.6349. And again, if you use your calculator, that will give you negative 0.9550. Okay, so let me show this on a calculator first. So first, your calculator should be set in radians. So cos of negative 0.6349. Negative, sorry, cos bracket negative 0.6349, which is negative, sorry, plus 8051 in 4dp. And if you go sine bracket 2 times negative 0.6349, close the bracket, that will give you negative 0.9550. Okay, so this is your x and y value. So you can graph this on a calculator by setting this in parametric function. Now this is 1, sorry, this is 2, and this is 3. So 1 is somewhere here. So this is 1, this is negative 1, this is 1, and this is negative 1. So the point that we're talking about is somewhere here. It's somewhere, 0.85 is somewhere here, 8051 is here, and negative, this is almost 1. So we're talking about a tangent which looks like this. A tangent which passes like this. So we want to find the equation of this tangent. And by just looking at this tangent, you can see the gradient has to be positive and your y-intercept has to be negative, somewhere between 1 and 2. Okay, so that gives you a visual understanding. So now if you want to graph this on a calculator, go to graph, and I already, suppose let me delete, exit, delete it. Let me first go to, this is generally you'll have in your graph, so go to type F3 and type in cos t and sine bracket 2t like this, close the bracket, and this is your graph. Okay, so this is what we're talking about, this point somewhere here. We want to find the tangent of the equation, sorry, equation of the tangent at this point. Okay, so let's differentiate it. We want to find basically what is dy by dx at this point. Okay, so the question is, what is basically, the question is, what is dy by dx? First, we'll find the gradient when t is equal to negative 0.6349. This is basically your question. If you find the gradient, then you can find the equation. Okay, so for that, first we have to differentiate. So what is dx by dt? Dx by dt is negative sine t. negative sine t, and dy by dt, you have to be careful, dy by dt here. Okay, I want you to think how to differentiate this. Okay, so differentiating this, you have to use the chain rule. Always differentiate the inside first, which is 2 times cos 2t. Cos 2t. So from this you can say dy by dx. Dy by dx is dy by dt divided by dx by dt, which is 2 cos 2t divided by minus sine t. And now the question is, you want to find dy by dx when t is equal to negative 0.6349. So directly let us plug this in the calculator. So go to your run menu and type in 2 cos bracket 2 times negative 0.6349, close the bracket, divided by minus sign, I'll put this in the bracket, negative 0.6349, which is 0.9997. So you can, let's write this and then we can say that's almost 1. So this is 0.9997. That's almost 1. We can say approximate that to 1. So the equation of the tangent, let me use a different color. So the equation of the tangent is y is equal to mx plus c. So you can say 1x plus c. And now we know a point. We know when x is this, your y is this. So let's substitute this in this equation. So you can say negative 0.9550 is equal to, what was the x value? It's 0.8051 plus c. Now moving to this side, so this is negative 0.9550, take away 0.8051 is equal to c, which implies c, if you use a calculator, your c would be minus 1.760. 760 in 3 dB. In 3 dB, this is here. So the equation of the tangent is y is equal to x minus 1.760. And that's the equation of the tangent.